the Dogues de Bordeaux, as his nickname, originated in France's Bordeaux region 600 or more years ago. He's known for his massive head, fearless temperament, and powerful body. The Dogues de Bordeaux first came to America's public attention with the 1989 release of Tom Hanks' movie Turner and Hooch, and has gained popularity ever since. Today in this video, we'll discuss 12 facts to know about Dogues de Bordeaux. Let's start! Number 12. Where they came from. There was also a dog breed very similar to the dog during Julius Caesar's reign in Rome. Additionally, the breed is thought to have ties to the Tibetan Mastiff, the Neapolitan Mastiff, and the old Dogues de Bordeaux of Aquitaine. Some theories assert that these dogs existed before the Bull Mastiff and Bulldog, while others believe the Bulldog contributed to the breed's development. Number 11. Key characteristics of Dogues de Bordeaux. The Dogues de Bordeaux is an old French dog breed with a stocky and powerful body covered with loose skin. The dogs have oval-shaped eyes set wide apart and come in shades of hazel to dark brown. Their ears are slightly rounded on the tips, set high on the head and fall back. The ears are typically a darker shade than the coat color. Number 10. Personality and temperaments. Dogues de Bordeaux may be members of the working dog category, but they're quite content to laze the days away, preferably near their owner. Despite their low energy, they make courageous, vigilant dogs and are devoted to their families. Number 9. Need socialization. Perhaps unsurprisingly, the Dogues de Bordeaux needs proper socialization as puppies to prevent them from developing serious problems, such as shyness and aggression as adults. The most bred members should prove to be relatively mild-mannered protectors who won't start fights independently. Number 8. Health conditions. All breeds are predisposed to various health conditions, and the DDB is no exception. According to a health information sheet from the Dogues de Bordeaux Rescue Incorporated, gastric dilation volvulus, hip dysplasia, and cancer. Number 7. They need enough exercise. Without enough exercise, these breeds may put on weight and vent their pent-up energy in ways you don't like, such as barking, chewing, and digging. Breeds that need many exercises are good for outdoorsy, active people, or those interested in training their dog to compete in a high-energy dog sport. Number 6. Often serve as protectors. It is known that the Dogues de Bordeaux took on a wide range of roles throughout their existence. They have been used to herd cattle and take on boars, which is a notoriously dangerous activity, even in the present. However, the Dogues de Bordeaux was particularly popular as a protector for the French elite, serving as guard dogs and watchdogs. Number 5. They're calm and quiet. The Dogues de Bordeaux isn't a breed that is famous for its aggressiveness. It is known for being a calm and quiet breed as full-grown adults. However, interested individuals should never forget that the Dogues de Bordeaux is fully capable of flying into action when sufficiently provoked. Number 4. They are quite easy for grooming. The Dogues de Bordeaux breed is well known for how much they drool, and the wrinkles on their facial area need special attention at least weekly, sometimes daily, to see that they're kept clean and dry. Number 3. Adapts well to apartment living. Contrary to popular belief, small size doesn't necessarily an apartment dog make. Being quiet, low energy, fairly calm indoors, and polite with the other residents are all good qualities in an apartment dog. Number 2. Affectionate with family and kids. Some breeds are independent and aloof, even if the same person has raised them since puppyhood. Others bond closely to one person and are indifferent to everyone else. And some shower the whole family with affection. Number 1. Used to be in two main varieties. Interestingly, there used to be two main varieties at one point in time, with one being the dog and the other being the dogueen. The records state that the dog was much bigger than the dogueen, which became less and less popular over time until it was reduced to its current status as a historical footnote. If I missed any information, please let me know by commenting below. Thanks for watching this video. You're invited to watch more videos and subscribe to our channel for more updates. Thank you.